an Israelite? Well, first of all, let me try to rephrase that question just for a second. What does it mean to be a true Israelite? First of all, number one, as a true Israelite, and I'm saying it the right way, the true Israelite, you have to be one that is committed to keeping the commandments. And I'm talking about the commandments of the Most High, y'all, that is outlined over in Exodus, the 20th chapter. All right, you start there and you read it. That chapter right there talks about keeping the commandments. Because that's the same thing that Jesus said in John 14, 15. If you love me, then what will you do? You will keep my commandments. And what commandments are those? Those are the same commandments that he's spoken to us from the very beginning. As a matter of fact, the Bible says, if you are going to be Israel, because remember he says that he has not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So contrary to popular belief, he hasn't been sent to Christians. He has not been sent to Muslims. He has not been sent to any other factions, distractions, religions, sects, cults, whatever you want to call it. He hasn't been sent to any of them. Christ has only been sent to his people. And of course, then he gave the marching orders to his people, gave them the message, and they were charged to go out and minister this gospel, minister this particular word to people of all nations. That's what they were charged to do. All right? So, in ministering his word to all nations, we're charged to make sure that we disseminate the right word, the same word that the apostles and the prophets had given out, so that we can make sure that the word is not tainted. Now, what has happened is that we've had other religions, such as Catholicism and Christianity, try to displace and practice replacement theology and try to actually get rid of our ancient people, insert their people into the book, and cause a bunch of confusion. And that's what's basically has gone on today. Because my church fathers is Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Moses, Solomon, David, Paul, Peter, James, John, and Yahshua HaMashiach, commonly called Jesus Christ. The Christian church fathers is Marcion, Tertullian, Ignatius, Charles Spurgeon, Wesley, Calvin, John Calvin. You can go on down the word. And then see, when you change the message, you change the people. And if you want to see how spiritual these commandments are, just start keeping them and see how much your natural family will start hating you. Watch and see how the world will start hating you. And watch and see how you're going to start feeling a lot of this dissension even in your own house. Like Jesus said in Matthew 10, start at verse 34 and read to the end of chapter, and he'll tell you clearly who your foes are going to be. You see, if you suffer persecution, because remember, through much tribulation shall you enter into the kingdom of heaven. But if you suffer persecution, then great is your reward. And you're going to suffer persecution mostly from religious people in the hour they're living in. Pretty much the world leaves me alone, you know, and pretty much. But the religious folks, it's a total different thing. And of course, you're going to be a true Israelite. You got to get filled with the Ruach HaKodesh, which is commonly called the Holy Spirit. And you get filled with it. You need to be baptized in the name of Yahshua HaMashiach, or Jesus Christ, and start keeping the commandments, live a set apart life, and he will bless you.